Hello everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Dr. Zarifa Ramadova and today I'm going to tell you about the benefits of vitamin B6. Vitamin B6 is used for preventing and treating pyridoxine deficiency and the anemia that may result. It is also used for heart disease, premenstrual syndrome and depression, as well as to reduce morning sickness in pregnant women and even with certain types of epilepsy. Be sure to watch this episode till the very end. I have so many interesting things for you. Let's go. All B vitamins are water soluble and vitamin B6 is not an exception. This vitamin is found naturally in many foods and available as a dietary supplement as well. The human body absorbs vitamin B6 in the small intestines, more specifically in the jejunum. It is excreted 8 hours after ingestion and, like all B vitamins, must be replenished with complete food or supplements. There is some evidence that vitamin B6 may be produced by gut bacteria in humans, but only in those on a fiber-added plant-based diet. In general, vitamin B6 helps the body to maintain normal nerve function, produce antibodies. Antibodies are needed to fight many diseases. Make hemoglobin. Hemoglobin carries oxygen in the red blood cells to the tissues. A vitamin B6 deficiency can cause a form of anemia. Break down proteins. The more protein you eat, the more vitamin B6 you need. Keep blood sugar, glucose in normal ranges. Now we will talk about this and many other effects of vitamin B6 in more detail. Natural Medicine's comprehensive database rates effectiveness of different drugs and supplements based on scientific evidence according to the following scale: effective, likely effective, possibly effective, and so on. According to this database, vitamin B6 is effective for seizures. Administering vitamin B6 intravenously controls seizures in infants that are caused by vitamin B6 dependence. I will tell you more about the use of vitamin B6 for epilepsy at the end of this video. Sideroblastic anemia. Taking vitamin B6 by mouth is effective for treating an inherited type of anemia called sideroblastic anemia, a condition in which the body makes abnormal red blood cells that build up iron. Vitamin B6 deficiency. Obviously, taking vitamin B6 by mouth is effective for preventing and treating vitamin B6 deficiency. Vitamin B6 is likely effective for high levels of homocysteine in the blood. Taking vitamin B6 by mouth, usually with folic acid, is effective for treating high homocysteine levels in the blood. Homocysteine is an amino acid produced when proteins are broken down. A high homocysteine level, also called hypohomocysteinemia, can contribute to arterial damage and blood clots in the blood vessels. Vitamin B6 is possibly effective for age-related macular degeneration. Some research shows that taking vitamin B6 with other vitamins, including folic acid and vitamin B12, might help prevent the loss of vision caused by an eye disease called macular degeneration. Atherosclerosis. As people age, their arteries tend to lose their ability to stretch and flex. Garlic and other ingredients seem to reduce this effect. Taking a specific supplement containing garlic, amino acids, and vitamins such as folic acid, vitamin B12, and vitamin B6 seem to reduce symptoms of hardening of the arteries, which is called atherosclerosis. Kidney stones. People with a hereditary disorder called type 1 primary hypoxaluria have an increased risk of forming kidney stones. There is some evidence that taking vitamin B6 along with magnesium can decrease the risk of kidney stones in people with this condition. However, it doesn't appear to help people with other kinds of kidney stones. morning sickness in pregnant women. Some research suggests that taking vitamin B6, usually as pyridoxine, improves symptoms of mild to moderate nausea and vomiting during pregnancy. The American College of Obstetrics and Gynecology considers vitamin B6 a first-line treatment for nausea and vomiting caused by pregnancy. Premenstrual syndrome, PMS. There is some evidence that taking vitamin B6 as pyridoxine by mouth can improve PMS symptoms, including breast pain. The lowest effective dose should be used. Higher doses will increase the chance of side effects and are not likely to increase the beneficial effects. Tardive dyskinesia. Tardive dyskinesia is a movement disorder often caused by antipsychotic drugs. Taking vitamin B6 seems to improve movement disorders in people taking certain drugs for schizophrenia. Vitamin B6 is found in the wide variety of animal and plant foods: beef liver, tuna, salmon, chicken breast, turkey, fortified cereals, chickpeas or garbanzo beans, or nut as we call them in Russia. Some vegetables and fruits, especially dark leafy greens, bananas, papayas, oranges, and cantaloupe melon. The good news is that about 75% of vitamin B6 from a mixed diet is bioavailable. However, vitamin B6 is easily destroyed during long-term storage, canning, steaming, and frying meat, boiling, and other food processing, as well as with alcohol consumption. Vitamin B6 is available in a wide range of doses, from 50 to 500 mg, both separately and as part of the B-complex and multivitamins. In order to avoid deficiencies in other B vitamins, pyridoxine should be taken in equal amounts with B1 and B12. It can be purchased in prolonged-release formulas that provide sustained dose of a medication over an extended period of time, lasting up to 10 hours. And the recommended dietary allowance for men ages 14 to 50 years is 1.3 mg daily, 51 plus years 1.7 mg. The RDA for women ages 14 to 18 years is 1.2 mg, 19 to 50 years is 1.3 mg, and 51 plus years 1.5 mg. For pregnancy and lactation, the amount increases to 1.9 mg and 2 mg respectively. It's worth pointing out that therapeutic doses can be significantly higher. A tolerable upper intake level is the maximum daily dose unlikely to cause adverse side effects in the general population. The upper intake level for adults 19 years and older is 100 mg daily, with slightly lesser amounts in children and teenagers. This amount can only be achieved by taking supplements. Even higher amounts of vitamin B6 supplements are sometimes prescribed for medical reasons, but under the supervision of a physician, as excess vitamin B6 can cause toxicity. Vitamin B6 is the generic name for six compounds, vitamers with vitamin B6 activity: pyridoxine, pyridoxal, and pyridoxamine, and their respective 5-phosphate esters. Pyridoxine 5-phosphate, pyridoxal 5-phosphate, PLP, and pyridoxamine 5-phosphate, PMP. The last two are the active coenzyme forms of vitamin B6. Vitamin B6 concentrations can be measured directly by assessing concentrations of PLP, other vitamins, or total vitamin B6 in plasma, erythrocytes, or urine. Plasma PLP is the most common measure of vitamin B6 status. PLP concentrations of more than 30 nanomol per liter have been traditional indicators of adequate vitamin B6 status in adults. However, the Food and Nutritional Board, FNB, used a plasma PLP level of 20 nanomol per liter as the major indicator of adequacy to calculate the recommended dietary allowance for adults. A mild deficiency may have no symptoms, but a more severe or prolonged deficiency can manifest in lethargy and drowsiness, or conversely irritability, as well as loss of appetite and nausea. Patients develop dry dermatitis in the area of the nasolabial fold, above the eyebrow, around the eyes, sometimes on the neck and scalp. The skin becomes dry and uneven. Chelosis may appear, vertical cracks in the lips, especially in the center of the lower lip, as well as angular stomatitis, cracks and sores in the corners of the mouth. In case of pyridoxine deficiency, inflammatory changes in the tongue, conjunctivitis, polyneuritis of the arms and legs are also possible. People with vitamin B6 deficiency could suffer from sideroblastic anemia. Taking vitamin B6 by mouth is effective for treating this inherited type of anemia. Infants with vitamin B6 deficiency are characterized by seizures resembling epilepsy, hypochromic anemia, growth retardation, hyperexcitability, and gastrointestinal disturbances. In pregnant women with a deficiency of this vitamin, many symptoms are noted, such as nausea, persistent vomiting, loss of appetite, irritability, insomnia, dry dermatitis with itchy skin, and inflammatory changes in the oral cavity and tongue. Certain conditions can increase the risk of developing a deficiency by interfering with the absorption of vitamin B6 or promoting increased use of it. Pregnancy, long-term excess of proteins rich in amino acids, tryptophan, methionine, and cysteine in nutrition, increased body need for pyridoxine due to the effects of environmental factors, heavy physical activity, walk in the cold, psychoneurological stress, etc. Taking medications that suppress the formation and metabolism of pyridoxine in the body, antibiotics, sulfonamides, anti-tuberculosis drugs, intestinal infections, liver disease, kidney disease, and radiation sickness, autoimmune intestinal disorders like celiac disease, ulcerative colitis, and Crohn's disease, autoimmune inflammatory disorders such as rheumatoid arthritis. It is quite unlikely to reach a toxic level of vitamin B6 from food source alone. Vitamin B6 is a water-soluble vitamin, so that unused amounts will exit the body through the urine. However, a toxic level can occur from long-term very high-dose supplementation. Supplements with vitamin B6 are likely safe for most people when used appropriately. Taking vitamin B6 in doses of 100 mg daily or less is generally considered to be safe. Vitamin B6 is possibly safe when taken in doses of 101 200 mg daily. In some people, vitamin B6 might cause nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, stomach pain, loss of appetite, headache, tingling, sleepiness, and other side effects. Vitamin B6 is possibly unsafe when taken by mouth in doses of 500 mg or more daily. High doses of vitamin B6, especially 1000 mg or more daily, might cause brain and nerve problems. Vitamin B6 can interact with certain medications, and several types of medications might adversely affect vitamin B6 levels. I will give you some examples, but in any case, if you are going to take vitamin B6 supplements like any other supplements and medications, you should discuss it with your doctor. The physiological function of vitamins B1 and B6 is to potentiate each other's action, which manifests itself in a positive effect on the nervous, muscular, and cardiovascular systems. Patients with Parkinson's disease should not use levodopa and vitamin B6 at the same time, as this vitamin can reduce the anti-Parkinsonian effect of levodopa. If you are on contraception pills, you are more than likely to need higher doses of vitamin B6. People who consume large amounts of protein need additional amounts of this vitamin. Vitamin B6 can reduce the need for insulin in diabetics, so insulin dosage has to be adjusted to avoid low blood sugar. Pyridoxine supplements are needed in patients with tuberculosis who are treated with a broad-spectrum antibiotic, cycloserine. Otherwise, they could develop seizures and neurotoxicity associated with this drug. People with arthritis, a disease of the joints, who are treated with penicillamine should take pyridoxine supplements. This vitamin works best when combined with vitamin B1, vitamin B2, pantothenic acid, vitamin C, and magnesium. Some anti-epileptic or anti-convulsant drugs, including valproic acid, carbamazepine, and phenytoin, increase the breakdown of vitamin B6. This results in low vitamin B6 plasma concentrations or low levels of pyridoxal 5-phosphate, PLP, and high homocysteine levels or hypohomocysteinemia. In anti-epileptic drug users, high homocysteine levels might develop several adverse consequences for the human body, in particular, increase the risk of epileptic seizures, raise the frequency of systemic vascular events, including stroke, and reduce the ability to control seizures. Furthermore, patients typically use anti-epileptic drugs for years, increasing their risk of chronic vascular toxicity. Anticonvulsant drugs, which are usually given to control seizures, are ineffective in people with specific epilepsy called pyridoxine-dependent epilepsy. This type of epilepsy is a condition that usually manifests with prolonged seizures involving muscle rigidity, convulsions, and loss of consciousness, tonic-clonic seizures. People with pyridoxine-dependent epilepsy are medically treated with large daily doses of pyridoxine. If left untreated, they can develop severe brain dysfunction and encephalopathy. That's it for today. If this video was useful for you, make sure you hit like. Definitely subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that all these actions will help many, many people watch this video. Next time we will talk about vitamin B12. Take care of your body and mind. See you.